The death toll in the Assam massacre has risen to 52 as militants, remember, opened gunfire on tribals in three districts in the state yesterday, resulting in these deaths.
Earlier, we have with us MOS Home Kiren Rijiju. Sir, how do you see this massive violence? More than 50 people have died. Obviously, the heads have to roll. Do you think there was information which came in late, or do you think this is a failure on part of intelligence, either of the center or the state?
I would not like to state anything on the failure part, because the attack is on the innocent people. Now, the innocent people in the villages are the victims of this gruesome, act of the militants. The question is that how we ensure that every peace-loving common citizens feel safe. That is the primary concern. Now, the Assam state has asked for the additional 50 companies that we will mobilize. And there has to be close coordination between the state agencies and the central agencies. We should not talk about any contradictions. This is a time to act combined, and nobody should say anything. It is all the agencies.
Militancy has been a huge challenge in the Northeast. Do you think this is obviously a blot in terms of having this amount of violence on innocent people? Do you think this is a setback, especially because Home Ministry has been trying to have peace talks with Northeastern militants, including NDFB's one faction?
As I said, peace and development has to go together. Without peace, the development process will not go ahead. That is why we have to ensure peace. If we have to, develop Northeastern region, it is very, very tragic incident when our government, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and the whole government is putting efforts to transform Arunachal, Northeast, Assam, Meghalaya, Manipur, all the Northeastern state into economic hub, a trading hub, and transform the area into prosperity. And this kind of incident is a blot in our whole process. That is why we have to take it seriously.
One question. This is regarding Assam's handling of the situation. We've seen earlier a lot of people from Northeast move towards different areas. We've seen an MMS happening there. We've seen different levels of violence continuously happening in Assam. Do you think this obviously questions the capability of the Gogoi government?
I will not, state anything about the failure or inefficiency on any part. As I said, this is a time to go together, work, combine and join hands together.
हमारे साथ बात करने के लिए इस वक्त हैं किरण रिजिजू, उन्हीं से बात करते हैं. सर, आप सीधा सीधा बताइए किस तरह से आप ये पूरा वायलेंस देखते हैं.
And Kamaljeet Sandhu now joining us live for more on the story. Kamal, we understand that Rajnath Singh, besides condemning the killing of these innocents by, remember, these NDFB militants in Kokrajhar and Sonitpur districts of Assam, we understand that the Home Minister will be chairing a high-level meet. And as we see on our screens right now, these are, in fact, the visuals coming in of a moment of silence being taken for those who have lost their lives in these brutal serial attacks that took place yesterday in the state.
Well, definitely so. At around 1 o'clock, the Home Minister will be chairing a high-level meeting which will compromise the IB chief, the CRPF DG, also other security forces. But this is seen as a massive setback, especially to the peace in the northeastern region. And remember, there have been peace talks going on with the NDFB, other faction, which has joined hands with the government in terms of having peace in the region. But this is the other faction which is opposed to the peace talks, which has obviously shown on the terror side of militancy, and that is how we've seen this huge setback happening. We spoke to Kiren Rijiju, and he obviously said this is obviously a blot on the democracy and an entire effort by the Narendra Modi government to have peace. And remember, the flight could have gone much earlier, but it's only because of the fog and the intense weather, inclement weather in Delhi, which is leading to some certain delay. But obviously, even as the plans are being firmed up of the ministers leaving for Assam by this afternoon, the fact remains that this has brought a huge focus to this entire region, which has been militancy prone. There are these small groups in Assam which have been a cause of concern. Also remember, during the DG's meet, the biggest threat coming in was from the Assam groups itself. 10 days ago, we know also that there were 10 IEDs which were formed. So there was some sort of violence. This could be seen as an intelligence failure, considering that there were considerable inputs which were coming in very, very regularly, especially from the Assam region. Tarun Gogoi himself had mentioned that he was trying his best to have some sort of action against these particular groups. And we've seen the repercussions of that, with these groups coming together, attacking in 5 different places, attacking the tribals as well as the Adivasis. So this is seen as a huge setback as far as peace process is concerned.
Right, Kamal, thank you so much for bringing us that update. Let me quickly go across to Manogya, who's joining us live from Kolkata as well. Manogya, if you can just give us an idea of what the situation is currently on ground. We understand that the death toll has risen to 52, a staggering number there.
Well, absolutely, Sanjana. The number is now to 30 to 52 now, which is not only a huge amount, but also the fact that several families have been affected in this firing that took place yesterday. We have also heard from the state government. They are asking for extra deployment of the central forces and also paramilitary forces. Important officials have been rushed to the spot. Adequate measures are being taken as far as the people are concerned. The injured people are concerned. They are being provided the first aid in the Barpeta hospital and the nearby hospitals. We also told that there has been a curfew that has been imposed in the area. Not many vehicles are being allowed in the region, and also a combing operation has been started by the state government in accordance with the central government that will ensure that no more such activities take place. Interestingly, we've seen that the trigger to this incident was a stern action promised by Chief Minister Tarun Gogoi, after which the incident took place, where the massacre took place and where hundreds of these several people were killed brutally in the villages and when they were returning home or when they were at home. Most of the people who have been targeted are tribals, are mostly Adivasis who've been residing there, and these NDFB militants have been demanding a separate Bodo land. Remember, despite the Bodo members being a part of the government in the center, there one of the BPF member is a supporter of the Modi government at the center. Despite that, such kind of incident taking place of course highlights the kind of measures that are yet to be taken by the central government as well as the state government.
Manogya, thank you so much for bringing us that update. Remember, this is as the death toll has risen in Sonitpur and Kokrajhar. The state is currently on red alert after these brutal series of attacks.